If she actually brings a Korops into the fort, it'll be one for the history books.
All the scorpions.
Oops. Looks like we're not done yet. The Sentinels are going on a raid. I need you to head out and join them.
Okay.
I'll head over there.
Hope the Sentinels get rid of those scorpion eggs.
Okay.
protein eggs. Better eliminate the rest of the hostiles now.
Finish.
girl in the market, Serna? I'll have to add more shielding.
Phone?
Yeah.
Did you have a good nap? Have a good nap?
Hello, freelancers. Well, only one in particular.
Owen.
Missed having me in your ear, did you?
What the hell do you want?
Ooh, and Faye, too. How quickly I've been replaced.
Answer her question. What the hell do you want?
I'm still working that out.
Whoa.
What matters now is you're headed for trouble.
Do you know where I'm...
The Dominion aren't fooling around. You've gone from a minor nuisance to a serious impediment. They'd like you to stop. Breathing, that is. Once and for all.
That's not negotiable.
They aren't asking. Palak's in over his head. They're gonna ambush him, take him off the map.
What?
Why are you telling us this?
I don't know. Feeling nostalgic, maybe? For simpler times?
You mean when you weren't a complete traitor?
Now that stings. Sure, I might have made a few risky career moves, but look. I'm not a monster. Just... want you back. Bye now.
What a bastard.
Bastard. Always sounds better when the British say it. Bastard.
Bodies, not Halleck's at least. Dominion. Owen was right. It was an ambush.
Maybe Halleck turned it around on. Okay, that's the fortress.
Any sign of Halleck?
Pretty quiet. Nothing so far. I'll look around.
Not loving the idea of being back here.
What could go wrong?
Halleck! Over here.
You almost got yourself killed. Why didn't you call me?
Although,
this looks pretty impressive.
It was Owen.
Owen?
Yeah. That two-faced bastard came out of nowhere. He's a crap pilot, but... that javelin is something else. Oh, I got a few, but not enough.
I cannot see this being anything but a positive update. There is no
you know,
way that WWE is going to promote the
freelancer is all I ever wanted to be.
And a GMA appearance.
It's all I do. I got no family. Poured every bit of me into being the best. Chasing my dream of the Legion of Dawn.
I can't see the read their stories so much I can recite them from memory.
Yeah, me too. You know why? You taught me. Taught most of us.
I don't want to be a teacher.
Hal, this isn't about you. Being a freelancer is about the team. You showed me that.
Yeah. Well, look who's back. Here's that two-faced bastard now.
Oh, you've got a lot of nerve.
Is it strange seeing me pilot this javelin? You never recognized my unique talent.
Oh, and the monitor did?
Yes, he did, actually.
I heard that didn't really work out.
No, but for a while it was brilliant. The Dawn Shield came up. I was magnificent. You should have seen me. Then, of course, it didn't hold. Seems it needs her signet, but I suspect that you know that already. So naturally, disaster, retreat, failure. In any case, my punishment. The Dominion and I have since parted ways.
Well, I think you learned your lesson.
Oh. And I think you are very lucky I was there to save your ass.
It seems your legendary capabilities were oversold. Just a touch. Hold on a second.
Oh yeah, that's from your mama.
Faye must have pulled the blueprints from the fortress. That's very clever. So you are still heading to the Senate.
Said it was studying fuel.
It doesn't work. Does it? No, it doesn't work. Not even with her signet. Oh dear, how very upsetting.
Okay, playtime's over. Give us the general's.
No. This belongs to me now.
Oh, and I swear to God.
This doesn't concern you. We need to talk.
Go get the Strider. I'll see you back in Tarsus.
Ganya said as much. He said that your brains is still recovering, and it's
two-faced bastard
from an in-ring return. He said that he was working out with him. He was definitely moving slowly.
Look, we were partners. Even friends.
If you hadn't just saved Alec's life,
I've heard it.
Even the summer. Maybe SummerSlam or something. They could build
the anthem. I've heard it too.
He's ready to come back.
I understand how it can drive a person to do terrible things.
Okay.
I watched the monitor hear it again. He's become crazed. He's got this machine, this weapon. And he's going to get it to the Cenotaph any way he can, even if that means dragging it across a bridge of his own dead soldiers.
Okay. Thanks for the heads up.
I'm sorry. When I looked yesterday, his name was not there. I know I don't deserve your forgiveness. They'd have his name listed. But I'm hoping I can make amends. Maybe even save your life. Here. Take this, my friend. I mean, I'm sure you probably would have worked it out eventually, but there's no time, is there? Just get Faye to reverse engineer it, fix your shield, build a hull load, blah, blah, blah.
Where are you gonna go?
At WrestleMania.
I'm not really sure, to be honest. East, west, you know. Again, I am sorry.
Right. You're sad.
Yeah, not just for that. I'm sensing a whole load of Dominion Furies heading this way right now. Ooh, they seem particularly nasty. You should be fine, though. Good luck, hero!
Owen, you son of a bitch.
This could be one of the last shield photo ops that we get. Maybe he'll announce.
The little turncoat became a turncoat again.
Hey, what is this?
Sorry, Owen wasn't kidding. A Fury, top of the line Dominion. But you're a top of the line freelancer, right?
Gotta find out.
What the fuck is that?
More of them coming in.
Guess we really pissed someone off, huh?
You should be flattered.
Right! Every bullet's a compliment.
Oh, Captain Fury.
I don't sound so surprised.
We've got bigger problems out here.
A Halleck?
I didn't get very far. I'm outside. You need to see this.
I like where he's going with it. That shit's a work that's going to hurt that company. Big time.
To take all of that into account and still think that this entire thing has been one elaborate work. You honestly believe that they would take that risk? Round and round about cancer.
Place depression everywhere.
You were born with a brain for a reason.
But just save yourself. No, no. It's all or nothing, Alec.
There's a difference between having...
Get wrong. Worry about the suppression machines. Okay.
Hey, we're not gonna last long out here.
We need an extraction.
Hoping you can work a miracle.
I'm on it. Hang tight.
My fingernails.
I got him.
You mean you can really mean it this time?
Use your geography, find the car, and ambush works both ways. And don't ever retreat. If you do, you're dead. It's gonna be forward momentum. Put them on their heels.
Easier if I can fly.
Yeah, I'm working on it. Bam. Looks like this flight suppression has a backup in place.
Freelancer, there's a generator nearby. That might solve it.
Try. I'm on it. Alec, try to disable the generator now. Hang tight.
Yeah, sure. I got nowhere else to hang.
Thank you. waiting on this stupid generator.
Patience, kid. Lose your cool and you lose your head.
You're not exactly a patient guy, Alec.
Off duty, maybe. But in the line of fire, you gotta stay in the moment. Start losing focus and you'll miss the bullet coming straight at you.
I thought he was legitimately talking about the hurricane.
Look, I can't believe
believe you brought a gun to work. Go home.
Who was it that brought the gun?
Bruce Pritchard, that's how he got
fired. Oh, now he's back.
Very interesting. What happened was,
oh, yeah. He's not gonna leave the gun in the car.
Is he willing to do that? Because then that might be
just a
if
fluke.
He's just being, you know, installed to be a stooge and go along with whatever Vince McMahon wants. I don't really see what that accomplishes.
Usually with those top tail ones,
at the end of the day, it's still Vince McMahon in charge. I'm skeptical that anything is really going to change. But you know what? A lot of what we see on TV, a lot of what we see on Raw, primarily every single week, the way the show is laid out, it's so boring. I'm interested to see what, if anything, he adds to the show. Even noticeable, or what might change about the show if he really does have that much power. I am so desperate for change on this show that I say, sure.
Why not?
Although I have to admit, when I first saw that headline, and the headline on the site was "Major Creative Name Returns to WWE," my heart sank. I thought it was someone else. I was relieved when I saw Bruce Pritchard.
He thought it was fucking Vince Russo.
When he went to work for TNA the first time,
waiting for him to say
and
that would
took
be
over
hilarious.
From Russo as the lead creative voice in the company, this would have been, I want to say, later in 2011 into the beginning of 2012. That was around the time that I started watching Impact full time. Yeah, I had watched Impact, but never really on a full time, every single week basis. Not for many years anymore. Got back into Impact on a week-to-week basis. In fact, I think it was the episode where Brooke Hogan made her debut, and Brooke Hogan was coming
it's
to the
awful.
It so happened that her debut was being promoted for that show. I want to say like May of 2012. But there was a period of about, I'd say, 6 months to a year, maybe even a little more, where I watched that show consistently every single week, and I enjoyed the hell out of it. Despite aces and eights and all that, which I wasn't a big fan of, I'll even go as far as to say that most weeks, TNA was better than what we were seeing on WWE television. What we were seeing on Impact was far better than what we were getting on Raw. And this is going back to when John Cena and CM Punk and those guys were the top names on the brand. Raw still wasn't all that great. It was better than it is now. But I would say that Impact was the superior show. Some people would say that now, even. Although they're not nearly on as big of a network as they were back then. So, if Pritchard had anything to do with that, I think he did. I think he was probably overseeing things at the time and had a pretty heavy hand in creative. And you know what? I'm on board to give the guy another shot and see what he might be able to do. Because if he fails, Vince will just get rid of him again.
And that'll make for funny material.
It still feels like
yes, it would.
To me. I don't think it speaks very well to the fact that they have an army of writers working for them. And still, the old man doesn't think that's enough. He's got to dip back into his old bag of tricks to try to fix a problem that he himself created. The man in charge is still the same. Nothing changes in that respect. That's why I kind of laugh every time I hear a story like this about some big creative hire, some big creative move. And I think to myself, in the end, what does it matter if the same person overseeing creative is the same man who has overseen creative for the last 30 plus years? You talk about wanting to bring new ideas and a new vision. I'm sure a lot of those people backstage have some pretty good ideas. It doesn't matter if they're filtered out and they can't break through to the man in charge. That's going to be the question. Let's see if anything actually changes. One thing I find encouraging is that I know from comments that he has dropped on his podcast that Pritchard is a fan. He's a fan of a few people, but he's a fan of Matt Riddle. And he thinks that Matt Riddle can be a huge star. I concur. On NXT this week, they aired part of a sit-down interview at the Performance Center with Riddle. It was conducted by Jeremy Borash, which I think is the first kind of interview they've had Borash do. Maybe they'll let him do more like that. This was what they aired on television was a condensed version of a longer interview on YouTube where he talks about wanting to be the man, and he's talked about this before, wanting to be the man to retire Brock Lesnar. He all but guarantees that it's going to happen. He's going to be the guy to retire Brock Lesnar from pro wrestling. I've said before, I think he should do it. I think he should be allowed to go ahead and work a program with Brock Lesnar, or work a WrestleMania match or whatever, and be the guy to have the distinction of retiring Brock Lesnar, whether it's a year from now, 2 years from now, 3 years from now. Matt Riddle should retire Brock Lesnar, and they should use that as a way to cement him as one of the top stars in the company. I actually think, I'm looking at what he signed and everything, and kind of the lay of the land right now in wrestling, I gotta tell you, I think he signed with WWE too early. You know, I was so hung up like a lot of people were for so long. How come WWE isn't signing this guy? He's working with Evolve and all these different promotions, and it was like they were dancing around him. They were signing all the people. They wouldn't sign Riddle. And I knew about the pot thing, and I said, this guy is too talented. You can't tell me they're not signing him just because of that. You can't tell me there aren't people in WWE
every
single week. Why are they not signing this guy? I said that for the longest time. And now I'm looking at it. You know what? Maybe he signed too early. When you look at the state of the wrestling scene right now with Ring of Honor and AEW and the money that these people are throwing around, I don't know what WWE is paying Matt Riddle.
Look who it is. You certainly know how to put a javelin through its paces. Never just go for a stroll out there, do you?
Do you expect any less?
I shouldn't. You've got your sights set on the Heart of Rage. Not the first time for you either. All part of the adventure, right?
I wouldn't trade it for anything.
I wouldn't know you if you did. I took my son to the platform earlier. We watched the freelancers take off. He said he's going to fly out there and do something awesome. It's not the worst dream to have.
Are you less worried about him becoming a freelancer?
Oh, I'll always worry. I worry about all of you.
You can't get rid of me that easily.
I run routine maintenance checks. I probably could.
What?
I'm kidding. I put enough work into those javelins of yours. You better bring them back.
Is that why you do it?
Not everyone comes back. Happens every day. The little touches, they improve the suits, but they mean someone cares. You're not just another number. You said the fort's your home. Just my way of keeping the lights on for you.
Actually, whether he intended this or not, I think it was a very shrewd move on his part, because it put the ball very publicly, squarely in WWE's court, when he made public the fact that he requested his release. He didn't announce that he was released. He just said, I want everybody to know that I have gone to WWE and I have requested that they release me. Now let me say all of these wonderful things about them and butter them up so they'll give me what I want. And in the end, he got it. Because look, if WWE didn't give him his release, they would come up looking like jerks. Which I guess hasn't stopped them before.
Hey, something wrong? Nah, this is just me being contemplative.
That's one happy-ass cat right there.
Giving you a howling pearl of wisdom that'll matter. And I think it's this. Don't ever believe you're immortal. Want to make your mark? Become a legend? Then assume the next fight is your last.
A week or two ago, I think I may have even featured him
But it's not. I don't fight to lose.
No freelancer does. I didn't.
But waiting around for your moment thinking it's going to happen tomorrow just means it won't happen today. You haven't been waiting around, have you?
Of course I have.
I was collecting it up today.
Our rage messed me up. I didn't want to admit I was the weak link. I was getting old.
Figured I had all the time in the world.
No.
But none of us do. You write your own legend today.
Nice.
Not mine. Ours. And that's the other piece of advice. Never go it alone. Some young freelancer attitude taught me that. Funny. I learned it from some old cranky freelancer. Sounds like they could be friends. We beat this, and there'll be plenty of time to find out. You know where to find me.
Was he going to drive by and pick it up? Want me to make the run for you?
I think they squandered that. You know, as usual, they didn't seem to have much of a plan when they called him up. Beyond the clever spot at the Royal Rumble a couple of years ago when he came out in the number 10 spot, he got one of the biggest reactions of anybody that night in the Alamo Dome.
Strider arrived last
week. They never pushed him seriously because they clearly never had any intention of doing so. Now, when he was originally in developmental, he was in OVW, he formed a tag team with Cody Rhodes. When Cody was brand new to the business. They won the tag team titles together. And then Dillinger turned heel. And he feuded with Cody until Cody.
I'm going back to the academy to teach. I accepted the offer. Me, nurturing young minds, sharing my passion with a whole new generation.
They said, no, we gotta put our own spin. We'll call him Gavin. So he became Gavin Spear.
I hope that means more Aruna calls in Fort Tarsus one day.
It might mean more Matthias's.
We're full up on Matthias's, actually.
I'm going to miss our chats. Stay in touch.
I'll try. Speaking of messages, have you told your mother?
Not yet. I'm going to surprise her in Antium. I hope she smiles. Maybe even laughs. I'd like to see her laugh. I'm glad you took the time to talk with me when you could have been, I don't know, sipping through the sky. If you ever fly over the academy, make sure you drop in to see me.
I will.
To die down. It's like, you know, Rusev Day. All these things, they run their course. That's why the key is to capitalize on them when they're hot. Do something with them when they're hot. See if they can sustain it. Maybe they can. Maybe they are a one-trick pony. But they never took full advantage of it. They never did much with the guy. That was it. That was the beginning of the end for him. I think he could have been. He could have gotten to that U.S. title level. There's no reason why he couldn't have done that. But honestly, that's about as high as I think he was going to go no matter what. He's not somebody they were ever going to build around. And maybe he shouldn't be. But he is another example of a talent that they just did not have a place for.
I've discovered something in the Elysian manuscript. Repeating symbols spread throughout the text. A pattern that once decoded shows a set of coordinates.
Coordinates for what?
Unknown. Robin Moore, its primary author, must have buried them in the manuscript. Moore was one of the greatest arcanists in history. His understanding of shaper instruments was unparalleled. I don't like making assumptions, but what's at these coordinates must be remarkable.
Let me guess. You want me to check out the location?
Precisely. Will you?
Leave it to me. Hi, Bren. How are you holding up?
Freelancer. Good. You remember that sixth missing sentinel? The one we couldn't find in the mines? I've discovered a weak signal. Very weak, but it could be him.
I'll track him down for you.
With earlier losses, we're short-handed and... Oh, thank you. The sentinels appreciate... I mean, I appreciate it.
A guy like Dillinger, I think, could be a great utility guy.
They do need to be careful, though, about one thing. They have to be careful, I think, not to come off like TNA did for a while.
Nice.
As being the place where all of the WWE mid-card guys and all of the WWE cast-offs
again
go to play. You know, AEW becomes their new sandbox, and all these low to mid-card guys can just, you know, get cut or ask for their release, and they'll kind of run off to All Elite Wrestling. They have to be careful because, call flips, trips, and falls. You know, you kind of start to build a perception after a while that you're just sort of picking up the scraps. But I
hello.
Think
hi, Prindle.
Fair warning, I am in a dark and foul mood.
Anyway, I can cheer you up.
There's a chance. You could help me with some perspective.
I'll try. What's going on?
My foot traffic initiatives were defeated. I've made zero progress on the loose cables hazard. And my proposed standing water bylaw is now dead.
That sounds tough. So what's your plan?
My plan is to leave the fort.
If you ask me, I think you should stay.
That's kind of you to say, but my future lies in Antium.
Why would you move to the capital?
Because it's filled with bureaucrats and politicians who like making rules and consider personal safety a priority. Those are my kind of people.
They are, huh?
It's terrible to admit, but I feel I've wasted my life trying to make this fort a better place to live.
I think you've made this fort better.
Why do you say that?
Because you've always been more than just a safety guy.
That's true. I've always loved maintenance.
Yeah, you made a real difference there, right?
Well, we've cleaned up the market. We're improving facades, and our horticulturalist has done some lovely planting. You've just made me realize I have made our fort a better place to live.
You sure have.
And I have unfinished business here.
What's that?
The fountain in the courtyard still isn't functioning.
You sound determined.
I am. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got a fountain to fix.
So now he is a free man. Or at least he will be again. Maybe 90 days or so.
The look on your face.
DJ Perkins. Now we get to the crew who was not let go.
Seriously, I'll go run for you if you need me to.
DJ Perkins was also released, unlike Dillinger and Itami. This was not something that he requested. On Twitter, he said that the boss, that being, I assume, Vince, not Sasha Banks, said that he respected his effort. He respected
10 years? I miss so much. Freelancer, look who I found. Cordae Adele. I'm told I owe you my freedom.
I have to ask, what was it like in there?
A kind of twilight fog. But at least I wasn't alone. And you haven't aged a day. We had no sense of time passing. It's hard to explain. I experienced my past, present, future.
There you are. I was so worried.
Beautiful.
Amazing news. You're fifth in line for the throne of Antium.
What?
I abhor gossip. But apparently, the Emerald Abyss has captured several people with claims to the throne. Now that everyone's back, they've had to completely rearrange the order of succession.
Am I still third in line?
My goodness, no. 12th.
Beautiful.
I'm sure this ordeal has been exhausting. And you're keen to get home. My luxurious Strider is at your service.
Didn't you hear? Your Strider caught fire at the docks.
What?
Big, fancy, engulfed in flames. That yours?
The rest is out of my hands. I'm doing my best. I promise you that they won't.
So, you were saying?
Yes. This is going to sound a little crazy. She saw the future. You and the freelancers are legends. It's not that crazy. Maybe. Now that I'm free, those memories are fading. But I do know you changed things for all the freelancers. Good, bad, I don't know. But don't worry, I'll be there with you. And you're going to teach me to be a cartographer. It's a hard life, Dax. Look what happened to me. Psh, I'll make new mistakes. This is who I am. Your parents will be so angry. Don't worry. I've got a freelancer. Thank you for everything.
Things of that nature, but it just didn't fit with what they wanted. That's what he was told. He said it wasn't my call.
What are you thinking?
In other words, he was fine. This wasn't surprising to me.
before the ticket.
After that tweet storm he went on after during Raw last Monday, he saw on the fundamentals why he's the writer. I don't know if he was a human talent. I just saw the writer, but he accused somebody behind the scenes of literally stealing an idea that I wrote.
cases, but boy,
all right.
Everybody was over back then. It felt like everybody was over.
This is nice. Secret spot.
Yeah. Takes a little extra to quiet Cypher's mind.
You doing okay?
Oh, yeah. Fantastic. Just questioning the nature of existence. Why I'm here. Why you're here. The Shapers, the Anthem, life, friendship, hope.
So, just a little thanks. Would you rather be alone?
No. I'm glad you're here. You know, when you first showed up at Princess Sims, I wasn't sure this was going to work out.
So then why call Tass?
Right, I was desperate.
Hey, what's up, dude?
Actually, any hesitation was more about Hyatt than you. I wasn't sure he'd ever accept you back. And then when he said, welcome aboard, it's fantastic.
What?
I've watched him come alive since you came back. He's up early, working on his suit, poring over maps.
Is he coming here?
Thank you for that.
Oh, she said you were coming here.
Never mind Halleck and me. What about you?
Yeah, me? I'm at the house.
Well, let's see. It's my fault that the team's broken.
All right, cool.
That our mission failed, and Tassin's about to send
Sentinels
in, probably to their deaths.
Bye.
And yet, with all that...
Yeah, he's coming by.
I'm mostly upset that I won't ever hear the anthem again. That's crazy.
I think that's right? What it was.
Seems to have that effect on people.
Plus, I've hurt my oldest friend.
Where is he?
I don't know. He doesn't speak to me much.
Okay, we're good.
Look, I get it, but please don't take all the blame. I've brought you something. Owen gave it to me.
Owen?
Fun story for another time. What do you think? Can we use that to perfect ours?
Yes, of course. Why don't you lead with this?
You're my
friend. She sounds like Garnet.
You know, like a good person.
This is amazing. Have you told Tassin?
Not yet. I needed to make sure Owen wasn't, lying.
Fair point. Well, he's not. I'm going to let her know we're back in action.
Okay. I'll meet you at Halleck's Javelin in the Enclave.
Halleck.
We'll figure it out. Our people need us to stop the Monitor. No one, nothing is more important.
Yeah. We're actually going to do this.
Fay, F-Y-F-A-Y-E.
Bitching. Bitching about her not going in on her. Speaking of the whole D-Generation X was announced as the headline attraction for this year's WWE Hall of Fame class. Triple H, Shawn Michaels, X-Pac, Road Dogg, Billy Gunn, and yes, Shina. All be inducted together Saturday, April 6th.
Freelancer. Any progress with my husband?
Nadira, I have to tell you something, but I'm not sure how.
This doesn't sound like good news.
No.
Then it depends on how bad it is. In Corvus, I sometimes massage the news to avoid even worse damage. So let's hear it.
What's
is
that?
Is Leighton okay?
Leighton's made a breakthrough.
Close it out.
That's the good news. The memory that's bothering him, he knows what it is.
That's fantastic. You mean Aurora?
Well, that's also the bad news. Leighton, he isn't really a defector. You're Aurora.
Of course. Damn, I had a bad feeling about this. Part of me did, anyway. I didn't want it to be true. But when you mentioned Aurora, it connected some dots.
I am glad I could help. I don't really know.
I'm sorry it went like this. I needed a neutral party to work it out. If I'd confronted him directly, I don't know what would have happened.
Now that we know, we've still got an enemy agent living here in Fort Tarsis.
But he's not an enemy to me. My feelings for him aren't a lie. I don't think his are either.
Maybe the persona's feelings for you, the latent programmed by the Dominion, but the real ones underneath.
Did you speak to him? The real one.
The real Leighton said he still loves you. He pulled away because he doesn't want to lose you.
That's good to hear.
Yet you seem worried.
If Tassin finds out...
It is her job.
I know. And her job will be to handle Leighton. It won't be good. If you don't mind, it's time we both talk to him. I'll meet you there when you're ready.
Brought you something, Alec.
Ooh-hoo! This is good!
Owen thinks it's the key to making the Dawn Shield work.
Owen!
He knew you'd figure it out eventually.
That's nice of him, I guess. Two-faced bastard. Hey, listen. I was thinking about what you said. About being a team. My ego... That was probably hard to say to my face, but I needed it. Thanks for the kick in the ass, partner. Has Faye seen this? Cause I can't figure this out on my own.
As luck would have it, here she is.
Halleck?
Faye?
I am so sorry.
No,
I...
Faye. I'm sorry. I used to be the best damn freelancer in all of Bastion, but not anymore. Pisses me off. I forced you to go behind my back because I didn't want to be a burden.
Caring about a friend isn't a burden. It's a gift.
Let's get to work.
Okay.
There it is.
Thank you. Oh, we'll take care of this. You go make sure everything else is ready to head into that storm.
Got it.
Okay.
Fantastic stories, though.
I think to say that would take away from the fact that he was a talented guy who did benefit, but he was a talented guy who I think would have done pretty well for himself either way. But yes, absolutely, he benefited from what's part of two of the biggest factions in the history of the business. He was part of the NWO.
Geico presents eyewitness interviews with inanimate objects.
This is Brian Bruno live.
Hey, I think back to the time Nichols was already inducted back in 2011. Look, if Bret Hart does go in for the second time this year, you knew that Shawn was going in too. I mean, that should have been a no-brainer. For Triple H, this will be his first induction officially, which I think is stupid. I think a big name like him should get their own solo induction first. Then if they want to do faction introductions, keep you in later on. So this one just feels like it's backwards, but... You know, look, they need names. They need to sell tickets. They need an attraction. DX is an attraction. Waltman is a worthy entry from his early days, in believing it was. Lightning Kid, he made a name for himself, doing some pretty innovative stuff for that time.
What the fuck was that?
He got him noticed, they got him a job. In WWE at a time when there really were not very
did you throw something?
Like
yep.
twice about it. That match with Razor Ramon on Raw in 93, the first one they had, not the rematch where he almost...